fount of every blessing, to my heart to sing thy grace. Streams of mercy never ceasing, call for songs of loudest praise. Teach me some melodious sonnet, sung by flaming tongues above. Praise the mount, I'm fixed upon it, mount of thy redeeming love. Here I raise my Ebenezer, here by thy great help I've come, and I hope by thy good pleasure safely to arrive at home. Jesus sought me when a stranger, wandering from the fold of God. He to rescue me from danger interposed his precious blood. That day when freed from sinning, I shall see thy lovely face. Clothed then in blood-washed linen, how I'll sing thy sovereign grace. Come, my Lord, no longer tarry, take my to carry me to realms of endless day. Oh, to grace, how great a debtor daily I am constrained to be. Let thy goodness, like a fetter, bind my prone to wander, Lord, I feel it, prone to leave the God I love. Here's my heart, oh, take and seal it for thy courts above. Here's my heart, oh, take and seal it for thy courts above.
My life flows on in endless song above. I hear the sweet, though far off, hymn that hails a new creation. Through all the tumult, endless strife,
Grace, mercy and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Very warm welcome to all of you who are joining us for worship today. I'm pleased that you're able to be with us. We know that we are continuing in the process of keeping the restrictions in place for a little while longer. Whilst we do, we are still meeting together in church, Sundays, 9 o'clock, in the morning, 2 o'clock each afternoon. You are all welcome to join us. As I say, I'm delighted that you're able to join us for worship here today. We're going to begin with our opening song, Join Me As We Sing Together. Let us confess our sins to our Lord, asking him to bring to mind those things of this past week where we have perhaps fallen short of living our Christian lives. The grace of God has dawned upon the world through our Saviour Jesus Christ, who sacrificed himself for us to purify a people as his own. Let us confess our sins together. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry and repent of all our sins. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life to the glory of your name. Amen. May God forgive you your sins and make you holy to serve him in the world. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, you have broken the tyranny of sin and have sent the Spirit of your Son into our hearts, whereby we call you Father. Give us grace to dedicate our freedom to your service, that we and all creation may be brought to the glorious liberty of the children of God, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We listen to our first reading.
The reading is taken from 2 Corinthians 6, verses 1 to 13. As God's co-workers, we urge you not to receive God's grace in vain, for he says, "In the time of my favour, I heard you, and in the day of salvation, I helped you. I tell you, now is the time of God's favour. Now is the day of salvation. We put no stumbling block in anyone's path so that our ministry will not be discredited. Rather, as servants of God, we commend ourselves in every way, in great endurance, in troubles, hardships and distresses, in beatings, imprisonments and riots, in hard work, sleepless nights and hunger, in purity, understanding, patience and kindness, in the Holy Spirit and in sincere love, in truthful speech and in the power of God, with weapons of righteousness in the right hand and in the left, through glory and dishonour, bad report and good report, genuine yet regarded as impostors, known yet regarded as unknown, dying and yet we live on, beaten and yet not killed, sorrowful yet always rejoicing, poor yet making many rich, having nothing and yet possessing everything. We have spoken freely to you, Corinthians, and opened wide our hearts to you. We are not withholding our affection from you, but you are withholding yours from us. As a fair exchange, I speak as to my children. Open wide your hearts also. This is the word of the Lord.
But this I know, that he was born.
Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark. Glory to you, O Lord.
That day, when evening came, he said to his disciples, "Let us go over to the other side." Leaving the crowd behind, they took him along just as he was in the boat. There were also other boats with him. A furious squall came up, and the waves broke over the boat so that it was nearly swamped. Jesus was in the stern, sleeping on a cushion. The disciples woke him and said to him, "Teacher, don't you care if we drown?" Got up, rebuked the wind, and said to the waves, "Quiet, be still." Then the wind died down, and it was completely calm. He said to his disciples, "Why are you so afraid? Do you still have no faith?" They were terrified and asked each other, "Who is this? Even the wind and the waves obey him.
This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Mike will bring us God's word this morning.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Gospel this morning is the very well-known story, the famous stilling of the storm. On the face of it, it's just another miracle. Jesus has authority over the natural world and stills the storm. I know it's my thing and I always go back to it, but in this case we do need to understand a little of the geography about the Sea of Galilee. It's about 13 miles long and 8 miles wide. It is Israel's largest freshwater lake and the second lowest body of water in the world. It's about 700 feet below sea level. Certainly a pretty unusual place. A great gale or storm arose. The Sea of Galilee was known for its fierce squalls, but they were short and sweet. As regular fishermen, they would have all have known all about them and how to deal with them. However, this one seems more furious than usual. "Don't you care, we're going to die," cry the disciples. Jesus calms the storm and all is peace. Just bear in mind Jesus' response. "Why are you afraid?" I guess it has something to do with sinking. "Have you no faith?" he says. Then he puts things right. Over the years, I have heard many uses of this story. What came to mind was a conversation I had with Colin last weekend about old hymns. The ones that you don't hear very much anymore, but still love. One of mine is "Will Your Anchor Hold in the Storms of Life? When the clouds unfold their wings of strife. When the strong tides lift and the cables strain, will your anchor drift or firm remain?" We have an anchor that keeps the soul steadfast and sure while the billows roll. Fastened to the rock which cannot move, grounded firm and deep in the hold. It's amazing how quickly storms can develop and how awful they can be at the time. Many of you know of my health difficulties of the past. There were times I felt like those disciples. "Wake up, don't you care?" Storms of life hit us from all directions and mainly out of the blue. I'm going to give you one of my little sayings that stood me well over many years. If you want to make God laugh, tell him what you're doing tomorrow. Just listen to that again. If you want to make God laugh, tell him what you're doing tomorrow. We, like the fishermen, can't avoid them. They are part of the natural world, but we can approach them in a different way. I know preachers say these things, but do they always do them? No. I fail as often as you do. When I ran this past Marion, she said, "That's all well and good, but it took a while to get your new kidney, and for some people it never seems to be peace and still." I understand and wrestle with that myself. The comforting thought that God has it in his hands, the outcome may not be what we expect, or even what we want, but he is there in the midst of the storm. Again, as the old children's hymn says, he's got the whole world in his hands. Storms come in many shapes and sizes, and usually not what we have planned. I never intended to retire early with chronic kidney disease, and I got cross about it, having given 30 years to the church and wanted to get some more. But somehow, we have to hold in our hearts the notion that Jesus was in the boat with the disciples and had it all in hand. My goodness, it can be tough at times. Will your anchor hold in the storms of life? Mine has certainly slipped and drifted a few times. What about you? So what do I want you to take away and think about this week? simply this. How do we face when one of those storms hits us in life? Do we think Jesus has it all in hand? Or do we get like those disciples? Wake up! Don't you care? So just remember how those disciples felt. Absolutely afraid. They thought their end was nigh. They even, to me, sound angry. We all fail and suffer from lack of faith from time to time. We all shout at God. Well, at least I hope we do. Don't you care? We all get outcomes we don't expect. But still, Jesus has it in his hands. Just sit with those thoughts for a few minutes at home and see examples in your own life where you have acted like our disciples or where you have held the faith. Amen.
Let's join together in the words of the Creed as we declare our faith in God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We come before God in prayer. Let us pray. Let us pray for the church and for the world, and let us thank God for his goodness. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father God, when the waves of life threaten to overwhelm us, teach us to find you in the storms of life and give us the faith those early disciples lacked to believe and trust that you will bring calm and peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those in authority, for our government, the opposition, and all decision makers, that they will act wisely for the good of all. As the rollout of the vaccinations has gathered speed, we give thanks for those who have worked hard to make this happen, for the volunteers, key staff, and all involved who have enabled this. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father God, as we see the brokenness of our world, we pray for healing among the nations, for fair share of the coronavirus vaccines, for food where there is hunger, for freedom where there is oppression, for joy where there is pain, that your love may bring peace to all your children. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for our diocese and Julian, our bishop, and his suffragans, Philip and Jill. Strengthen them and uphold them as they lead us, especially during this next phase of our diocesan vision of unlock as the restrictions begin to lift. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. In this month of June, a national month of prayer for all toddler groups, we pray for Little T's, our church toddler group here at St John's, for the children and their families, and all who are involved in helping. We thank you for the opportunities that gathering together presents, for the joy and the fun we share, and we pray that through these interactions, others may come to know of your love for them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father God, when our lives feel chaotic and desolate because of illness or sorrow, Help us to hear your holy word. For by that word, Jesus calmed the storm, and by it he healed and made people whole. We pray for those who have asked for our prayers, and for those known only to you. Help them to put their trust in you and in the knowledge and skills of those who care for them. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving God, we pray for those saddened by the death of someone close and dear to them, for members of our families who have died and whose anniversary we recall. Help us to experience the comfort of the Holy Spirit within us and the fellowship of the church family around us until we are reunited once more in your heavenly kingdom. We hold in our hearts those known to us who have died recently. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. As Jesus said, "Peace, be still." May we each hear those words afresh in our lives today, knowing that the one who calmed the waves of the Sea of Galilee is with us day by day. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Joining our prayers together as one, as Jesus taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Christ is our peace. He has reconciled us to God in one body in the cross, and we meet in his name and share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Where you can, let's share the peace with one another.
You lift me up.
During the prayers, I mentioned that we are entering this season of Unlock as part of our diocesan vision. We saw a video a couple of weeks ago where the bishops spoke about this period of unlocking. As we pray our diocesan vision prayer together, we wholeheartedly entrust to God the words that we're saying, that indeed as we enter into this phase of unlock, many more people will come to know of God's love. So will you join me as we share together in the words of our diocesan vision prayer? Heavenly Father, we embrace your call for us to make disciples, to be witnesses and to grow leaders and inspire children and young people. Give us eyes to see your vision, ears to hear the prompting of your Spirit, and courage to follow in the footsteps of your Son, our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. May God make you strong in faith and love, defend you on every side, and guide you in truth and peace. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you now and always. Amen. Let's sing together our closing song.
Creation sings the Father's song. Yeah.
creation longs for his return. When Christ shall reign upon the earth, the bitter was that rage of birth pains of a coming age. When he renews the land and sky,
delighted that you've been able to join us for worship. After the service at 11:30 this morning, there will be virtual coffee time. We've been continuing that. Everyone is welcome to join. Even if you've never been, you might want to come online and join us for that. If you've not got the link, please get in touch. Please don't be shy. Come along and join us. It will be good to share together. In previous weeks, I've mentioned about the hall renovations that we've got in the pipeline. We appointed a builder this past week, which I'm really delighted about, and we're really hopeful that the major work will start in September. We've got some grant applications that will be going in. The fundraising from the community has been amazing, so thank you to all of you who have contributed in whatever way. It's been truly amazing. We've got some grant applications that will be going in over this next week or so. And so on Monday evening, a number of us are coming into church at 7 o'clock just for a short prayer meeting, a 30-minute prayer meeting. If you're able to come along and join us for that, we'll be making sure that we keep our distance, but in church where we can just come together for a time of prayer, particularly asking for God's guidance and for God to bless all that we are doing with the hall and the renovations that we're wanting to make. So if you are able to come, it would be good to see you. Even if you're not, and I know some of you may be way too far away to come and join us at 7 o'clock, we would really value your prayers. So we will be meeting at 7 o'clock on Monday evening. If you could join us in that time of prayer virtually from wherever you may be, that would be truly wonderful. At 7 o'clock this coming Monday. It's been good that we've been able to worship together today, but go in peace to love and to serve the Lord. In the name of Christ, amen.
My ransom soul, he leadeth. Within your house forever.